be a part of Christ's holy baptism. For we know that it is not about the water itself, but what happens internally, on the inside of us. Because God is all about spirit, and we that worship Him and love Him must do so in spirit and in truth. And this is simply an outward symbol of adoption into the family of God. Jesus Christ Himself was baptized, and that is why we serve God and go through this holy baptism, because it is an outward show to the world of an inward grace and inward change. You'll find this on 33 in your temples. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without price. This morning, we have our own brother Mark Livingston. So today we present Mark for baptism. And Mark, I ask you these questions. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves?
Yes.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? Now we will ask you, congregation, for this is not a solo journey. We are put on this earth with the other 5 billion people to walk with one another, to strengthen one another. When I am weak, I lean on you, because then you are strong. When you are weak, then the same thing happens. We are to support one another. So I ask you, do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include this person now before you in your care?
With God's help, we will proclaim your claim to the Jews and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround this person with a community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their trust of God and be found faithful in their service to others. We will pray for him that he may be the true disciple who walks in the way that leads to life.
Let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water. After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you promised.
Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell of God's mercy each day.
In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus. He too was nurtured in the water of a womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations.
Declare his works to the nations, his glory among all the peoples.
Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and those who receive it, to wash away their sin and clothe them in righteousness, through their lives that, dying and being raised with Christ, they may share in his final victory.
All praise to you, eternal Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen.
Amen. Walk a blessed in the middle of your chapter. Mark, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And all the people said,
Amen. Amen.
The Holy Spirit worked within you, that being born through water and the Spirit, you may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Now, church, it is our joy to welcome our new brother in Christ. Through baptism, you are incorporated by the Holy Spirit into God's new creation and made to share in Christ's royal priesthood. We are all one in Christ Jesus. With joy and thanksgiving, we welcome you as a member of the family of Christ. Good heaven, let's give God praise. Let's give God praise. Let's give God praise.